Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Commodity TV and a new edition of our virtual online interview series. Today, we want to talk for the first time to C3 Metals. And Kevin Tomlinson, the CEO and president, is here with us. Hey, good morning to London. How are you doing, Kevin?
Good morning, Jochen. Nice to see you again.
Yeah, great to see you again. Long, long time since Cardinal Resources. I think you were one of the founders even there. And it was a big success, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, it was 140 million market cap up to 590 million market cap sale. It was a battle for 9 months among Shandong and Nord Gold. So it was really great.
Super. And so now you want to repeat that with C3 Metals, I could imagine. So what is C3 Metals about? Where are you working? Please give us a short overview on the company.
Yeah, well, C3 Metals, I started there in January, and we're in the land of the giants down in southern Peru with a big copper gold discovery right near Las Bambas and Constantia. So we've got neighbors of MMG and Teck and First Quantum. So it's quite a great neighborhood. We've just been drilling for the first time in 10 years there and intersecting some really high-grade copper with gold credits. So that's in Peru. And then also in Jamaica, that's been a real surprise to us. We've got some very nice porphyry intercepts that are 1 to 1.5% copper plus gold credits plus really high grade epithermal veins. And Jamaica, most people wouldn't know that there's anything mined but bauxite, but it has a really good copper gold.
Fantastic. So let's stick for a second with Jamaica, because that really interests me. I have Jamaica more like a holiday vacation or a center spot in my mind, and for rum and stuff like this, and for, let's say, having a good time. Mining, how did you come on Jamaica?
Well, the company started back there in 2012, actually, and then it was a joint venture. BHP first discovered the copper gold there, and then Oz Minerals came in and joint venture with the company. And since that time, Kurube, which was called Kurube, is now C3 Metals, has been exploring it. There's been $20 million spent to date, so a lot. And that whole area there, Jamaica's on a very large regional structure, and the island of Jamaica, in fact, is on a jog. So there's a lot of volcanics and all the really juicy bits that bring the fluids up. So a real surprise to everybody that we speak to about Jamaica. It's fantastic.
Okay, super. Do they have a mining code or, let's say, a good legal system?
Fantastic. It's based on the British system. There's five bauxite mines. It's the Spanish were mining copper way back in the 1700s, 1600s, and then the British were mining gold in the 1800s. It's 2 to 3 months for a drill permit. It's well set up.
Super, perfect. So what is the work plan there for this year?
Well, right now we're just compiling all the information, and we are looking to drill in September, hopefully, maybe even before. We've got 10 porphyry targets and also a couple of high-grade epithermal vein targets where we've been getting historic drill results of, 3 to 4 meters at 20 grams in that area, and also the big porphyries.
Okay, super, cool. Well, sounds like a game plan, I would say.
Oh, yeah. It's not just pina coladas and beaches there.
Yeah. That's good. Maybe you do that after work.
Maybe after work, yep.
Okay, let's move to Peru, because you are, I would call it, in elephant territory, definitely, with Las Bambas, Constancia, and you're like in the middle, as I saw on your map. I'm so very close to that. So Jasperite is the property you have, and you have 57 square kilometers land package. And also I saw in your presentation that about 10,000 meters were drilled historically into a high-grade copper gold skarn system. So this is quite common there, right?
Yes, that's right. I mean, if you look at the skarn mineralization, it's very similar to what Constancia was in the early days. There's another deposit called Pampatria that they're starting to mine. So it's a known type of deposit, and I guess the potted history was discovered in 94 by Cominco way back when, and they only mined it, explored it for 2 years, and then Briex hit, so the worldwide explorations basically stopped, and then Hochschild came in 2011 for 1 year and did some drilling, so and then they didn't advance it anymore because it was high-grade copper, and they're interested in gold and silver. So a deal was done with them, and that was folded into C3 Metals. And we, for the first time in a decade, have started on a 10,000 meter drill campaign, and we've finished 4,000 meters to date. We had a press release about 2 weeks ago for the first 7 holes, and fabulous intercepts, 50 to 80 meters wide at 3 or 4% copper, bonanza grades up to 12, 15% copper over shorter distances, and then in broad intercepts that are 120 to 150 meters wide at, 1.5% copper and plus gold credits. So,
Fantastic. Wow, that's super. And I think you guys are also in the middle of a 10,000 meter drilling program, but you're focusing on mineralization above 200 meters. So that's like from surface down to maximum 200 meters, right? Just to put that into a context. And I think you released also some 2 weeks ago already results. So 17 meters at 7% copper. That's not too bad, I would say.
Yeah, it's not too bad, and it actually starts. That's really good, and that's what really excites me about the project. When I first looked at it after leaving Cardinal, the board is outstanding. We've got Tony Mannini, who most people know globally, and Zimmy Mika, Yale Simpson, so very well known people, and a great executive team. So it was easy to step in there to help drive this forward. And what we found though is that this mineralization, one hole was drilled 650 meters to the north, and that one hole had 24 meters at nearly 2% copper. And so we've started in the south at 50 meter line spacings, and we're marching our way to the north. So, like I said, we finished 17 holes to date. We're awaiting assay results. So after we finish this first release, now we're hopefully going to be on a 3 to 4 week treadmill of assay results to just keep them going,
Okay, cool, super. And I saw also that you want to do an airborne MAC and IP surveys, which you have contracted and which shall also commence then in 2 weeks. Is that then on a different site or different space of the area? For what are you doing that?
Yes, that's a great question. So where we're focused right now is on 9 square kilometers of the high grade skarn. But in the broader picture, no airborne magnetics has ever been done before. So we're doing that. And w interestingly, in the core that we've just drilled, we've actually found fragments of what we think is the primary porphyry. It's got fragments in there with disseminated chalcopyrite. And we've also found drill core that has disseminated chalcopyrite in the alteration zone. So we're just starting to get into the sulfide. So the magnetics will pick up the skarn, so the very high grade magnetite that's in there. And it will also, now the IP is going to be the thing that's probing below this 200 meters of oxide into the sulfide to find the porphyry or a parallel horizon.
Okay. So it looks to me like, because I have in my mind, Cardinal has had like the same start, and we were talking already about Cardinal. So would it be also then your game plan to say, hey, we advanced this, let's say, production ready?
Yes, exactly. So first of all, we had to do the drilling to make sure it was real and that we're going to see how big we can make this oxide. We're going to go for the porphyry and parallel structures. But in the background, we will be doing metallurgy and all the things you need to do to bring something like this into production, because being oxide, it's much easier to bring into production. And on our board, we've got all the expertise necessary to not only understand it and study it and build it, but actually to finance it. So for us, that's great. And with neighbors like we've got, who knows? I mean, we haven't gone unnoticed, obviously, because there's big mills around us that would love extra feed,
Interesting. Great, good to hear. Super. So you have a game plan already in mind. I like that. Now we have spoken a lot about workflow, about drilling and all that kind of stuff, but it costs all money. So what is cash in the bank? And very important, what is management share in the company? Who are your largest shareholders?
So when I first joined, we had about $1.5 million in the bank, so we embarked on a capital raise of $4 million. The book was about $10 million, so we took 7.5. And then thankfully we have really good shareholders. A lot of warrants were expiring at the end of March, and then we got another 2.5 million from existing shareholders who are really happy with the progress. So right now we have about 8.5 million Canadian in the bank, so a good amount of
Nice.
money. And that'll last us easily till first quarter next year at the rate we're going. Should we want to accelerate it, be results based, we'd look at doing other things, but at the moment that's we're happy with that. Our shareholder base, with the context that the board has, of course it's international, so we have a lot of Australian, UK, European and North American investors. The biggest shareholders are RCF at nearly 8%, Ingalls and Schneider out of New York, again about 8%, that's Bob Gibson. And then Luxor just joined the register out of New York as well. Management insiders are about 15% of the company. And then out of the 65% roughly that's left, probably 30 or half of that would be high net worth that are contacts of the board who are very mining savvy. So they're all really excited about the scale potential, the neighborhood, the commodity. So it's great.
Wow, fantastic. But that sounds like a good thing. And I remember Cardinal started the same way. I love
It did, yep. We started slow and we grew it. Yep.
Super. Well, Kevin, thank you very much. It was a great first insight into your company. And I have a good feeling that we talk quite soon with your drill results. And
Yes.
yeah, I keep fingers crossed. Let the drills turn because this world needs a lot of copper.
We love drilling, and that's
Yeah.
good. Thanks a lot. Okay.
Super. Thank you very much,
Okay.
Kevin.
Bye now.
Thank you. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was Kevin Tomlinson, the president and CEO of C3 Metals. Yeah, for the first time at Commodity TV. And as of course, you might know him already from Cardinal Resources, which was a really big success with a great exit at over $500 million, where the company was sold finally. Shareholders made a lot of money. And yeah, it looks like that Kevin wants to repeat that here. And I think the basis for that looks quite good. The drills are turning $8.5 million, $1 million in the bank of cash. That is also fantastic, and already fantastic institutions in the shareholder registry. And what I really like is that 15% is owned by management, so they have skin in the game. I would suggest you have a look onto your company. Thanks for watching us, and please watch our disclaimer, which is following. Thanks. Bye bye from Switzerland. All the best.
Yeah.